TYBSC SEM FIRE class. Today I'm going to teach you topic from paper MB14. Title of the paper, that is Fundamentals of Immunology. Unit 4, Immune Tolerance and Immune Disorders. Let's first understand what is immunology. Immunology is the science which focused on immune responses to foreign substances and how these responses are used to resist infection. It also includes distinction between self and non-self and all the biological, chemical, physiological, metabolic and physical aspect of immune response. So before starting with the immune tolerance and immune disorder, let's first understand some basic or fundamentals of immune system. Class, in the bone marrow, lymphoblast cells are present, and from this lymphoblast cell, precursor B cells and precursor T cells develop in the primary lymphoid organ, that is bone marrow and thymus. Later on, from these, mature T cells and mature B cells are developed in the secondary lymphoid organ, that is lymph node and spleen. So mature B cell and T cells makes two arms of our immune system. When any antigen, so what do you mean by antigen? Antigen is a foreign protein or foreign substance or any microbial antigen or microbial agent which mount immune response when enter in the body is known as antigen. So when any complex antigen enter in the body, first it is received by antigen presenting cell. These cells are macrophage cell and they are phagocytic in nature. So here you can see that antigen binds to the surface receptor of the macrophage cell and engulfed by the macrophage cell, and inside the phagocytic cell they are processed, that means fragmented, and then a suitable peptide fragment that is presented on the surface of macrophage cell to the B cell as well as to the T cell. There are some other soluble antigens which are directly interacting with the B cell without undergoing process in phagocytic cell. So here we can see that antigen is processed by the antigen presenting cell, phagocytic cell, as well as antigen which are not processed by phagocytic cell interact with the B cell. B cell get activated or stimulated, and thus they proliferate rapidly, that means multiply rapidly, and produce a progeny. So newly formed activated B cell, they are differentiated into the mammary cells as well as some of them are differentiated into the plasma cell. Now this plasma cell produced antibodies, and these antibody react with the antigen. So this is the function of humoral arm of our immune system. Now the second arm, that is cellular arm, where T cell is involved. In the same way, macrophage cell, that is antigen presenting cell, they present the antigen to the T cell. T cell get activated or stimulated and proliferate rapidly, that means multiply rapidly in the same manner as B cell. And newly formed stimulated T cell, they get differentiated into the mammary T cell as well as in effector T cell. And these effector T cells produce cytokines which are interacting with the antigen and cause destruction of the microorganism. This is how our acquired immune system function normally. Now we will discuss acquired immune tolerance. So I think you must have understood this, how the immune system is functioning. Next, there are four characteristics of our immune system. First is, that is discrimination, that means differentiate between self and non-self. Then second, diversity. Third, specificity. Fourth, memory. So now we will study about acquired immune tolerance. What is acquired immune tolerance? Acquired immune tolerance is the body's ability to produce T cells and antibodies against the non-self antigens such as microbial antigens. And while tolerating or not responding to our self antigens. Let's have historical aspects of acquired immune tolerance. Various immunologists has contributed for the immune tolerance, such as in 1945, first described phenomena immune tolerance by Ray D. Owen. Then in 1953, the observation of Owens was experimentally validated by Lassell, Berendt, Rupert E. Billingham, and Peter Medawar. The theories of immune tolerance was formulated by Sir Frank McFarlane, Burnett, and Frank Fenner, who were the first to propose the deletion of self-reactive lymphocyte to establish tolerance. Now, new term is used, clonal deletion. But Burnett and Medawar were ultimately credited for the discovery of acquired immune tolerance, and they shared Nobel Prize in Physiology in 1960. This is the history of acquired immune tolerance. Now, some of this tolerance arises in early embryonic life, when just embryo is developing. And that time, immunological competence is just developed and being established. That time only, some tolerance to the self antigen is arise. There are three general tolerance mechanisms that have been proposed. First is negative selection by clonal deletion. Second, that is induction of energy. Then third, inhibition of the immune response by the action of T regulatory cell. Let's see first negative selection, that is done by clonal deletion. That means remove the lymphocytes that recognize the self antigen. There are some lymphocyte cells which recognize self antigen as a foreign or non-self, and they may cause damage or mount immune response, and thus they are to be deleted or eliminated. These cells are eliminated during embryogenesis, that means during the development of embryo, by apoptosis, that means programmed cell death. Here the T cell tolerance that is induced in the thymus, and B cell tolerance is induced in the bone marrow, as T cells get developed into the thymus and B cell develop into the bone marrow. And that is why this tolerance of T cells and B cell in the bone marrow and thymus is known as central tolerance. Many of the autoreactive B cells undergo clonal deletion or become anergic as they mature in the bone marrow. Here with this diagram, we will try to understand the central tolerance. So during the development of early lymphocytes from stem cells, a given stem cell undergoes cell division rapidly to form numerous progeny. A number of cells are developed from a single stem cell. And during this period of cell differentiation, random rearrangement of the genes takes place. That means the genes are rearranged in the cell, and that gives the diversity to the cell. And these genes, when expressed, they code for cell surface protein. They code for cell surface protein, and these cell surface protein function as a receptors for the antigen. So these receptors are formed, and the cells are genetically different from each other. They are known as clone. And each clone bearing a different receptor that is specific to react with only a single type of foreign molecule or antigen. Now, at the same time, any lymphocyte clone that have specificity for the self molecules that could be harmful are eliminated from the pool of diversity, and this is known as central tolerance or immune tolerance. Now, this specificity for a single antigen molecule is programmed into the lymphocyte and is set for the life of a given clone. The end result is an enormous pool of mature but naive lymphocytes that are ready to further differentiate under the influence of certain organs and immune stimuli. So this occurs in central tolerance in the thymus and bone marrow. If any cell escape from this tolerance mechanism, then the next occur in the peripheral tolerance, that is in the secondary lymphoid organ, where the cell gets stimuli from the antigen or any protein. So when this antigen enter into the body, this antigen reaches to the cell which has got receptor site for it and bind, then rapidly proliferate, increase in number, and mount immune response against antigen. So this is how our central tolerance is developed in the body. Sometimes immune system mount immune response against self antigen, and this is known as autoimmunity, because many of these self antigens, they are tissue specific and are not present in the thymus or bone marrow at the time of central tolerance development. And these antigens are developed later on, and that is why another mechanism is needed to prevent such type of immune reaction. Now, the immune tolerance mechanisms which are occurring elsewhere in the body are collectively known as peripheral tolerance. That means the B cells or T cell tolerance, which is escaped from the central tolerance, now that tolerance is achieved in peripheral tolerance, and these supplement central tolerance. Peripheral tolerance that is thought to be based on incomplete activation signals that is given to the lymphocyte cell when it is encounters self antigen in the periphery of the body, and this mechanism leads to a state of unresponsiveness that is known as anergy, and this is associated with impaired intracellular signaling and apoptosis. Apoptosis means programmed cell death. Next, the deletion of self-reactive B cells, that means the B cells which are reacting with the self antigen. So removal of this B cell takes place in the secondary lymphoid tissue such as spleen and lymph nodes. Now, since the B cell recognize unprocessed antigen, as I told you in early, there is no need for the participation of MSC molecules in these processes. For those self antigen which are present at very relatively low concentration, immunological tolerance is often maintained or achieved only within the T cell population. And this is just sufficient to sustain tolerance because it denies the help essential for antibody production by self-reactive B cell. Regulatory T cell with suppressor activity can inhibit B cell and other T cell activation as well as modify specific function. Here, we sum up acquired immune tolerance with this diagram. Mechanism one, that is negative selection. Negative selection having two arms, central tolerance and peripheral tolerance. Central tolerance achieved in thymus and bone marrow for the T cells and B cells. And the other tolerance mechanisms occur in the peripheral tolerance. So this is negative selection. Then second, energy, that is unresponsiveness, apoptosis, that is programmed cell death. And third, regulations by T cell regulatory cells and B regulatory cell suppressing the immune activity of the cells. Here the questions for the assignment for this particular subunit. First, describe the three ways acquired immune tolerance in the vertebrate host. Then define the terms energy, acquired immune tolerance, apoptosis, central tolerance and peripheral tolerance. Student, next topic we will start, that is immune disorder. Immune disorders, as disorders may occur in any body system of human body, so this disorders may occur in immune system. And immune disorders can be categorized as hypersensitivities, autoimmune disease, transplantation rejection, that is also known as tissue rejection, immunodeficiency. First immune disorder we'll discuss, that is hypersensitivity. Hypersensitivity is an overreactive adaptive immune response. It is exaggerated, that means overreactive adaptive immune response that results in tissue damage. And it occurs when an individual gets exposed to an antigen first time and again on a second time or subsequent come in contact with the antigen, this reaction occurs. That means our immune system mount over exaggerated reaction to the cell or to the tissue of our body that cause damage. Hypersensitivity reaction can be classified from immediate type to delayed type. Immediate type hypersensitivity reaction, where the reactions occur faster. Within a minute, reactions appear. But in the delayed type of hypersensitivity reaction, reaction takes time, maybe 72 hours, maybe 1 week, maybe 1 month or 1 year. But the main difference between them, that is the nature of immune response to the antigen. And realizing this factor, in 1963, Peter Gell and Robert Coombs, they have developed a classification system for the reactions which are responsible for hypersensitivities. Now their system correlates between clinical symptoms and immunological events. That means the clinical symptoms which appear during this reaction, they are related with the immunological events that takes place during the hypersensitivity reaction. So the Gell-Coombs classification system divide hypersensitivity reactions into four types: type 1, type 2, type 3, and type 4. Class, today we will stop here. In my next lecture, I will start with the type 1 hypersensitivity reaction. Thank you very much.